Hannah Clark was robbed of everything she held dear, her freedom, her children, her life, her identity. All that survived the flames was her footprint, her family now holding it as a symbol for change, and their campaign, Small Steps for Hannah.
We want to try and start something to help women who are in this situation, who have suffered domestic abuse.
Those small steps really matter, but there are big steps needed too. Today alone, police attended an average of 450 domestic violence call-outs around the country. In any given week, thousands will contact helplines, and we know that's just a small percentage of those who live in constant fear of their partners.
Since Hannah's death, our federal politicians have been quick to condemn what happened.
Australians all over the country are just shocked, saddened and devastated.
It needs to be called out, and it needs to be called out for what it is, a terrible murder.
But calling it out only gets us so far. What's missing from the language of our leaders is any commitment to spend the money the experts say is needed to deal with this scourge.
The government's only put just over $100 million a year into addressing this crisis. It doesn't follow that the action is matching the rhetoric.
Since Hannah's death, the government has announced $2.4 million for programs targeting violence. But that was money already allocated within the $100 million yearly spend.
No, it's not enough. If the government were actually serious about this, then they would put whatever funds were necessary to ensure that no woman or child was turned away from a refuge, to ensure that no woman or child or man going through this situation was denied legal help, and they would ensure that every man who requires behaviour change programs was able to access one.
It will take more than just the money. Pressure's mounting for a complete overhaul of the family court system. The Law Commission says power should be handed back to the states. It also wants to get rid of the premise that assumes both parents are equal partners in the custody process, regardless of the history of abuse.
What you see is children being disbelieved, protective parents being disbelieved, to the point where there's so much evidence sometimes for the fact that one parent is harmful, and yet it is all swept away with the idea that the child must have contact with both parents. It is so terrible what is happening in the family law system. I literally can't overstate how bad it is.
But instead of implementing these recommendations, the government launched the national inquiry, co-chaired by Pauline Hanson.
There are people out there who are nothing but liars and will use that in the court system.
Not exactly impartial.
I want politicians and police and people within the judiciary to just really look inside their hearts and go, if that were my family in Brisbane, what would I be willing to do to stop that from happening to anyone ever again? And then do that.